Okay, I hope I'm audible to all of you and you are visualize screen. One request, meanwhile during session, if I get interrupted because of certain network issue, please inform me. Okay. Okay, so shall we start? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so we'll start with our
first session. I think this one is the second one.
Well, you have already come across your session first based on power system. Yes. So let us start with this session number second. So this is AICT sponsor Prerna Center for all of these students, basically specifically for SC and ST students, conducted by Vidya Pratishthan Kamalayan Bajaj Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today we will be focusing on a guest lecture, a gate lecture on the subject power system. The topic we will cover is your performance of transmission line, then we'll see the line parameter and corona effect. Okay, this is your session number second. I am Professor Ramchandra Rakte, working as an assistant professor in BPKBIT Baramati. So let us start with the first intro of the power system. So before going to this, let us just visualize or recap the topic-wise weightage for your GATE syllabus 2022. So we are basically concentrating on the power system. So let us directly go on the first one, that is power system. It is a weightage, expected weightage. This is not what we are expecting. 9.75. So it's around, we can say, 10 marks in your GATE examination. And this is one of most heard of your GATE exam. Because the GATE exam, you know, this is basically conducted by the central authority and it is mostly useful for PSU examination, PSU industrial sector, higher education sector. So definitely being an electrical engineer, we are mostly bounded with the power system. Okay, so this is one of the most important as far as your GATE syllabus is concerned for 2022. Okay, so we can say it is approximately, we will expect 10 marks for the power system. Okay, so on this power system, we will be having certain points to be covered in this particular course. Or for this 10 mark course, you will be having certain points, not exactly from your all the, you should cover all your curriculum. No doubt, if you concentrate on certain selected topic, definitely we will cover or you will get a glance of all these 10 marks. Okay, so let us first understood which are these point which we'll need to cover in this power system. Okay, so we have, as I hope you already gone through a GATE syllabus, and in power system I will just highlight some topics. That is first one, that today we look for performance of transmission line, line parameter and corona. Apart from this, you will be having compensation technique, voltage profile control. Then you might come across distribution system, cables, insulator. So after studying this overall the concept, we look for the economic power generation and load dispatch. Then we will go for the switchgear section. So we look for fault analysis, power system stability, switch and gear protection, then generating power station. This generating power station is the most a basic part of the power system. After that, we will see the load flow studies, then DC transmission, per unit system. So these are some important points you can study based on the GATE syllabus. Okay, so out of this, you will be having 10 marks in GATE examination. Okay, so let us start with our first topic, that is your performance of transmission line. Okay, along with we will look for the line parameter, and as session will proceed further, we will look for the corona effect. Okay, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes. So let us start with the first one. We'll first recap the what is electrical energy. I will not read out here definition because we are focusing on the gate. So we'll definitely we will have that kind of approach. So when we talk about the electrical energy, definitely, okay. Before going to this, if you just
highlight the first sentence,
so they are saying progress of any nation is measured in terms of per capita consumption. Okay, now we are dealing with the power system, so that's why we can say per capita consumption of in terms of electrical energy. Okay, so
to know
what is the electrical energy consumption by our country, I have here mentions that India is using 500 kilowatt hour per person per year. Okay, now you get shocked. So this much amount of energy I am consuming? Yes. If you just go through your domestic electricity bill, I'm talking about domestic, not, I'm not talking about industrial and commercial. If you just go through this domestic bill, approximately one individual home is consuming 100 kilowatt. Am I correct? And if his consumption is very less, so might you might come across 60 to 70 kilowatt hour consumption per month. So I'm this talking about per month. This is a domestic one. Okay, so this consumption per year is not that much, but for the energy crisis, we are utilizing, instead of utilizing, we'll say we are wasting too much energy. Okay, and definitely, if you compare our country with others, definitely they are using much more, but they are also following some energy conservation rules. Okay, so why I have added this slide? Being a electrical engineer, we are also bounded to the society also to have to play our duties. Okay, so if you look into the current scenario, I will not go in detail. If you look into the current scenario, you know what's the condition of energy generation in current scenario. Okay, yes. So these are some aspects why there is a use of electricity is increasing. Popularity of electricity, and we are finding the reason behind it. Okay, so we'll just read out for the clean user, for a high efficiency, then controllability, source to load transfer increases, energy conservation is a simple example. So these are some reasons that we are popular in electricity market. But the most highlighting point is this one. If you just read out the progress of a nation measured in terms of per capita consumption of electrical energy, and this is too much. Okay, so I'll say instead of utilizing, we are wasting much amount of energy. Okay, so being this is my appeal to all of you. Be a responsible person for this country and try to minimize the usage. Also try to minimize or avoid wasting of energy, waste usage of your electricity energy. Okay, I hope this is much helpful to all of you. Yes, now we'll look into the scenario of power generation. Okay, yes, as we know, this part we have already covered, you have already covered in your basic of power system generation, power system generation technology, or basic of power system. So what do we understand? Basic electrical energy, whether it is domestic, industrial, commercial, so it is not possible to imagine our life without electricity. Yes, that is what we are on, where a number of fuels are being used to generate the electricity, number of sources are being used to generate the electricity, and this is among of them. So one is thermal, another one is hydro, another one is nuclear, and there are tremendous other source also. So I have just listed out in hierarchical order, in ascending order, that in thermal power, we are generating 1 lakh megawatt of energy. For hydro, we are using 65,000 mega of energy. From nuclear, we are generating 10,000 mega of energy. And other source, we will utilizing, we are generating 20,000 megawatt. Okay. And these are some power generation plant. Okay. So that's why I am here calling as power generation scenario in our country. I'm not talking about others' country. I am talking about ours country. So electrical energy, what you understood from this hierarchy? What you understood from this hierarchy? It means we will find that we are using a tremendous amount of usage of electricity in our domestic, in our industry, in our agriculture, even in our other kind of services. So the fact is electricity can be transported instantaneously. What we are dealing with, this is a generation. This is what? A generation. Correct? Now, okay, first we will complete this slide, then we'll move further. What we are looking for today's topic. Yeah. So the total installed capacity, if you just sum up this one, so this is nothing but a total installed capacity of a power generation in India. Correct? And you know the this much amount of power generation technology is there, this much amount of power generation are being there. Now, to utilize this, we need to, suppose this is my generation, this is my end user. End user, I'll say it's a consumer. So this is a distribution. One is that generation, one is that distribution. Between these, we need something. And that is nothing but your, yes, what that is nothing but your?
Transmission lines.
Transmission line, yes. And today's scenario, we are focusing on a transmission line parameter. Clear? Yes. So before going to our actual topic, first we'll have recap on this single line diagram. So most of the time we'll call it that SLD, single line diagram of power system. Correct? Yes. You most of the students have come across this one, a single line diagram. So what it shows, actually it is showing, it shows a power distribution path, a power distribution path from generation to the distribution, that is your consumer, with some aspect of your transmission. Okay. This is nothing but your single line diagram. So what do we get to know? So here we are using some kind of voltage system, some kind of a generator, some kind of a transformer reactance, some kind of line reactance. So all the aspects are being considered over this single line diagram. Okay. So if you say, if I want to elaborate only in one sentence, what I will say, single line diagram, this one is single line diagram, or sometimes it is called as one line diagram. Okay. One line diagram is a simplified way of representing three-phase power system. Okay, so you can observe here, it's a three-phase power system. We are representing only in terms of one line diagram. Correct? So in this one line diagram or single line diagram, we are representing, okay, what is the basic difference you observe here? In you might have come across circuit diagram, you might have come across connection diagram, and right now you are focusing on single line diagram. What is the main difference? Yes. So main difference is in single line diagram, we are representing in terms of symbolic form. We are single diagram is nothing but a symbolic representation of three phase electric power system. So you can observe here, this is AC. This is symbol for transformer. This is symbol for transformer. This is for distributor. This is a notation where the power is flowing. This is for large consumer. This is large consumer. This is for medium consumer. Means what? Single line diagram is showing certain types of symbolic representation in electrical system. But which type of electrical system? Three phase electrical system. Correct? This is the main aspect of single line diagram. Now, the question is why there is need of this SLD? Yes, anyone? Why? What is the importance? What are the features of this SLD? Okay, so basically importance feature of this, we will able to calculate amount of short circuit current. We are able to calculate is there in a select coordination between this equipment or devices or not. We'll able to calculate certain types of energy incident for this in generation to transmission to distribution. So all kind of scenario we will look for this single line diagram. Correct? Yes. So here we have summarized what do you need of this single line diagram and what is actually is your single line diagram. Yes. Now let us move further. Yes. So what they are saying here, there's we are moving actual today's topic, that is transmission line. So before that, let us understood what is transmission system or different types of transmission system. Okay. Yes. So when we are dealing with AC system, when we are dealing with the AC system, definitely we were having total single phase, two phase, three phase, and again the single phase are being classified according to their connection. So we look into in terms of transmission aspect, because our topic is what? Topic is what? Transmission line. We are looking for the performance of transmission line. Yes. So in single phase system, where the cursor is, okay. In single phase system, we are having single phase two wire, single phase two wire midpoint earth, and single phase three wire. Correct? We know we are having phase, we know we are having neutral, we know we are having earth. In two phase AC system, we are having two phase three wire as well as two phase four wire. And the most important and utilized in tremendously in our current scenario, that is three phase AC system, which is three phase three wire and three phase four wire. Can anyone tell me what is connection difference? Or if you are seeing a three phase three wire means which type of connection and three phase four wire means which type of connection?
Three phase three wire or delta type and three phase four wire star connection.
Very good. So three phase three wire we mostly come across the delta one, and three phase four wire we are mostly coming across star one. Now tell me why I'm elaborating this all concept in transmission, because what we understood in SLD, we are just representing as all the connection electrical, or we can say three phase electrical system in terms of their symbol. So in actual we are connecting a transformer, in actual we are connecting certain types of load through the lower large consumer or medium consumer. It means what? They are connecting their load through our substation. Okay. Yes. Okay. First, we'll clear this one. Okay. First, we'll look in detail of SLD, then we'll look for it where we actually belong. So, this is generation. Okay. All the powers are being generated in our electrical system is at how much? Generated
11
at?
kV.
Okay, it is only at 11 kV. Correct? And from this 11 kV to our this small end consumer, whether it is domestic, whether it is industrial, whether it is commercial, I'm talking about a basic consumer. Okay, small consumer, basic consumer, where they are utilizing either single phase or three phase. They are utilizing either single phase or three phase. If I'm saying single phase, so it is 230. If I'm saying three phase, it is 400 volt. Correct? That's it. So among from starting from the generation to the distribution, there is a change in this particular voltage rating. Either they increase or decrease. So to have this kind of arrangement, we are going to connect certain types of equipment in terms of their connection. So here connection is what? Now I have generated at 11 kV. If I want to supply it to the grid, if I want to supply it to the large consumer, then definitely I want to increase the energy level. I want to increase the voltage level to 132, 220 and 440 kilovolt. Correct? So that's why I will use certain types of connection diagram. So not connection diagram, I will use certain types of electric equipment. Then I will use certain types of transformer. So in transmission line, transformer is the most important role. Okay, along with its R, L and C element. Okay, so as we move further, we'll look for resistance, inductance and inductor. So after that, now here we have increased from 11 to 132, 220, 440. Here we have covered our first consumer, that is very large consumer, or the power being fed to the grids. So this part we are covered. See, what flow is like, we have generated and aim is to fulfill the demand from all the consumers. So whether it is smaller, whether it is larger, whether it is very large or whether it is grid, all demand should be fulfilled from this generation or our electrical power system. Correct? So as we move from generation to distribution, we will start fulfilling the demands from all the consumers. So in this first stage, what I have done, I have fulfilled the demand of large consumer and the grids. After that, there are some large consumer who are not required this much amount of energy, this much amount of voltage rating, this much amount of energy level. They are satisfied with 66 kilovolt range. So what I will do, I'll use another transformer and here I will step down my voltage. So here I will fulfill the demand of large consumer. So whether they are connected with the system. After that, we move to the distribution part. So distribution part where we are dealing with 11 kV, marking this in your mind, 11 kV, 33 kV, and the very small consumer, that is nothing but your single phase, three phase, 230 volt and 440. Okay. Now this is just a brief about SLD. Okay. Now we are concentrating on, here we are concentrating on which part? Transmission part. And in this transmission part, we will focus on which are the line parameter. I will not teach you what is the length of transmission line. Here I am going to teach you which conductor I am using for the transmission line. What are the performance of that particular transmission line? Okay, so we'll focusing on this part. Okay, yes. So these are the different types of transmission line. We are having single phase AC system. We are having single phase two-wire system, single phase two-wire midpoint or single phase three-wire system. Then we are having two-phase three-wire, two-phase four-wire, and the most utilized level is three-phase three-wire, three-phase four-wire. Along with, we are also having DC system, DC two-wire, also we can use DC three-wire. Okay, yes. So based on this, we will move further, that is why there is necessity of transmission line. Can anyone tell me? Why there is this necessity of this transmission line? Okay, I'll teach you this need of transmission. You tell me, what do you mean by short transmission line? What do you mean by medium and long? Yes, short transmission line. Okay, you tell me line length. I will tell you what does it mean. Length of short transmission line. Yes. Length of short transmission line. Whatever is, if it is wrong, it's okay. Just tell me. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, listen. We know short transmission line means what? Medium transmission line means what? And long transmission line means what? You know, it is about 50 kilometers or 60 kilometers. Some book they are written as 80 kilometers. This is the factor. But what short transmission line says, categorization of transmission line is nothing but whatever the length of the transmission line, accordingly, my line voltage will move on. Move on means what? For short transmission line, if we are having line voltage of about 20 kilovolt, then for medium transmission line, I will be having line voltage increase one. So if for short one, if I are having 20 kilovolt, definitely for the medium, I will move from it will, I will means it has the capacity of handling that line voltage about 20 kilovolt to 100 kilovolt. When I will move from medium to long, the line voltage capability gonna increase. Okay, so this is the basic of transmission line. So first let us see what is the need of this transmission line. Yes. What they are saying, first we'll read it. Bulk amount of power generations could able to produce economical by employing synchronous generator. Okay, this is the generation part. The bulk amount of power from the remote generating station could be carried out to the load center by using, this is most important, by using suitable network, and that network is nothing but your transmission network, or we can say transmission line. So what this is a what already we have covered. What they are saying, if you are generating, yes, it is okay. If you are distributing, yes, it is okay. Distributing means what? You have certain demand. See, when there is a business role is what? You are manufacturing something, you are producing something, and if there is no demand, if there are no consumer, will my business will run? Yes or no? You are manufacturing something, one industry is there, he's manufacturing something and there is no demand. Will I get profit? Will that particular industry get profit? Obviously not. Why? Because this is a thumb rule, demand versus supply. If there are, these are my consumer who demands for certain types of energy, and accordingly I'll start generate. Now, in our country or in the whole worldwide, there is no such wait for this generation of electricity. The demand is huge. So we are constantly generating the energy with the help of certain power plant. So you know this one. Okay. And to have this total flow means, suppose this is my particular industry. I'll just give a simple example. This is my industry. It is located at certain locations. Say it is located at Bandra. Okay. And the demand is from Lucknow. So to the Lucknow consumer, I will get this particular product with the means what? From this industry, I need one transportation system which will reach out this my particular product to the my demanded consumer. Okay. At the particular shops or directly, if you have order online, so it get directly. Means what? The transmission part is there. In same way, if you relate this example in our system, definitely whatever the economical consideration is there, whatever the generation is there, and whatever the demand is there, it is get load center means what? A certain type of load or certain types of demand from the user, and it get fulfilled by with the help of suitable network, and that is nothing but transmission network. So that the transmission network or transmission line is the necessity of our electrical system, and we are dealing with the power, so we definitely will say it's a electrical power system. Okay. Now we are reach at our basic or depth of topic, that is nothing but the parameters of transmission line or line parameters, or you can say different conductors or different types of conductor we are utilizing for transmission of line. Okay, so among these we are having certain four types of conductor. First one is solid conductor, then we are having stranded conductor. So stranded conductor is homogeneous and non-homogeneous. So this is actually one only, but they have classified in two way. Okay, and the third one we are having bundled conductor. Okay, but for our consideration we will say it is a four types of consideration in terms of transmission line. Okay, in terms of transmission line. So first is solid. I will recap for you. First one is solid, then stranded, then homogeneous stranded, then composite stranded, and bundle conductor. Okay. Yes. Now we'll start with the first one, that is solid conductor. This is figure number one. Actually, figure number one is about SLD, so that's why it is showing figure number two here. Okay, so this is solid conductor. Solid conductor means what? One conductor is there. Okay, first we'll read out and then I will explain. What they are saying, solid conductor is single piece of conductor. Okay, it is a single piece of conductor. Yes, it is. These conductors maybe of copper or aluminium. So these are dealing with the material of which they are made. Okay, so if someone asks in your gate exam, the material being used for the solid conductor is about, so it is about either copper, either aluminium. Correct? Yes. Okay. In your curriculum, apart from this, I will add on something. In your curriculum, you might have come across these types of conductor. Okay, so this material, this material is not limited up to the copper and aluminium. They are much more. There is a silver also. If you know, there is a silver also. Copper is already there. So I'll say here copper. There is gold also, which carry. What do you mean by conductor? Yes. As we are discussing the transmission line, parameter of transmission line, what do you mean by conductor? So there is silver, so copper is there, gold is there, aluminium is there. Okay. Apart from that, for your knowledge, I'll say there is iron also there with certain degree of composite material. Then steel is there. Then brass is there. So this is just for knowledge. Okay. Why I'm saying, apart from this, yes, is it feasible to use gold as a conductor? As we are living in a certain scenario where we are not able to find out the theft of our electricity, and we are using conductor, gold conductor, for transmission of this power. Is it so? Of course not. So among these are the types of material will be utilized for manufacturing of conductor, and among them we are using copper and aluminium. Okay, so this is I have just added to for your just sake of knowledge, that because I have seen most of the students have assumed till they have completed their degree that there are only copper and aluminium we are manufacturing the conductor. No, there are all certain material. There are certain materials, silver is there, copper is there, gold is there, aluminium is there, iron, steel, brass. Yes, these all are there. Okay, but among them, we are using copper and aluminium. Clear? Yes. What we are looking for? Solid conductor. Yes. So when we are saying conductor, what I am expecting? Its strength. Definitely, we have seen the material being used. Then we look for its strength. Now strength in terms of mechanical as well as tensile strength. Okay. How the shapes of the conductor? So here we have deal with the material. Here we have deal with the strength. And here we have deal with the shape or cross section of that particular conductor. So there we can say the conductor, if you have just come across the practical, if you see some practical conductor installed in our transmission, used in our transmission overhead transmission line, that is nothing but a kind of circular one. You can find it circular one. You cannot find in this kind of shape. Ya asa kadhi baghitla ka tumhi? Rectangular, square. Okay, so these kind of shapes are not allowed. Okay, these are only acceptable in circular shapes. Okay, because there are certain types of electrical field uniformity across that particular conductor. Okay, throughout the surface of the conductor, we get the maximum electric field throughout the surface of the conductor in which shape? Circular one. Okay, correct? Yes. So this is about solid conductor. Now, solid conductor means what? It consists of only one conductor. Now, it has certain limitation. That's why we are not utilizing this kind of conductor in our scope. But apart from this, what we are saying, the certain, what we are looking for, types of the conductor. So we are having total four types of conductor. First, you will look over this conductor, and in second half, we will solve the numerical based on this conductor. Okay. So first among them is, first one was solid conductor. Now let us move for the second one, that is homogeneous stranded conductor. Yes. Now, this is another one. They are saying it's a stranded conductor. Now, what do you mean by stranded? Stranded means this is one strand, this is two, this is three, this is four, five, six, seven. They are making number of conductor and get twisted to have certain types of strand. Why? To increase strength. Here we are using a certain regular one use of conductor for transmitting our power from generation to distribution. See, I'm always saying when we are generating power is not much concern, distributing power is not much concern, but how you are transmitting with the fulfill or demand of all these consumer, that is the most concern. Okay, so that's why we are now, if you know the current scenario, our India is changing. India, we are moving from overhead to underground. Okay, so if you are now living in certain urban area, you will find out there are certain works are going on for underground electrification. Am I right? Have you observed this one?
Yes, from
last 1 or 2 month, or from last this pandemic situation, the electricity section has got much more opportunity to work on. So you can observe, we are changing our scenario from overhead to underground. Okay. Yes. So for second part is nothing but homogeneous stranded conductor. So what they are saying, first we will read this one. Number of strands are taken. Okay. We have taken number of strands. Suppose this is 1, 2, this is 3, this one is 4th, this one is 5th, 6th and 7th. We have taken 7 strand and then we have twisted. Why? To increase the current carrying capacity by maintaining same operating voltage. This was not achieved in solid conductor. Solid conductor, no. There was only the one conductor is there. Strand mean inside the number of conductor. This is nothing but strand. Okay. But in case of homogeneous standard conductor, now this homogeneous and non-homogeneous means what? We will look it. Homogeneous means if you just see the diameter of this each conductor, it is same. So they are of same diameter, same cross section. That is nothing but homogeneous. Okay. Homogeneous and non-homogeneous, this is the basic difference. And the rest of the procedure will remain same. What we have done? We have taken certain number of standard. So I have taken here 7. So it is not means it is always 7. That's why in definition, just I'll rub it. Otherwise you will assume this is 7. No, these are not a fixed number, these are saying a number of strands. Okay, number of strands are taken and then we have twisted to, so what is the purpose? To increase the current capacity and to maintain the operating voltage. So operating voltage means what? Whatever we are transmitting from sending end to the receiving end. So when we are belonging to the transmission line, here we will come across to this scenario, that is sending end and receiving end. Okay. Now one might ask, sir, whether this conductor is of copper and this conductor is of aluminium, this conductor is of gold, whether it's acceptable? I'll say no. It should be of same material. Okay. It should be of same material. Why? Here we are using copper and aluminium. Here also we are using copper and aluminium. What is the main difference? What it makes sense? We are using in technology. So what kind of technology we are using? We are using certain methodology where instead of taking one conductor, so I'll say this is my solid conductor. And when there is a bunch of solid conductor comes together and they are twisted, then it is nothing but homogeneous standard conductor. So homogeneous means nothing but same cross section. That's it. So this is one solid conductor, this is another, this number of solid conductor get combined and twisted. So there is a formation of stranded conductor. And believe me, this is not only limited to your GATE syllabus. This is the most important thing when you go for work on substation part, when you work on some switchgear assembly part, or when you work on something control panel part. So there are the certain conductors, certain cables we are utilizing for our electrification. And at that time, it's a duty of that particular electrical engineer. It is a duty of that particular design engineer who will able to select a valid type of conductor for my electrification. And that's why we are learning these types of conductor used in our transmission line power system. Correct? So first one was solid. Now this one is stranded. Okay. Yes.
Now tell me, in our childhood, we have seen one example. लाठी भी क्या होता, ठीक है, and they try to,
I'm not remembering that particular story, but yes, the moral of the story is equitable. Have you heard this story? Yes. Have you heard this story, equitable? Yes, of course, all of us have shared this story. So means what? If you combine these certain things at one location, at one point, then definitely what going to increase? Its mechanical strength. That was the drawback in this one.
So the also your tensile strength. So most of the part is nothing but your strength of your conductor going to increase. Okay. And by looking to the economical aspect, we will say stringing is easy in standard conductor, so transportation is easy. So transportation part is, just assume there are
certain 7 conductors or there are a certain 100 conductors to carry these conductors, a bunch of conductor at one place, that is standard one, or a single 100 standard conductor. Which one is easy for the transportation? Definitely standard one. So definitely whatever the drawbacks, what are the loopholes of particular particular solid conductor, they are being eliminated in homogeneous standard conductor. Okay, shall I move further? Yes, shall I move?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So after homogeneous, we will look for composite standard conductor. Okay. So in last session, tumhala manlo hoto ki whether it is acceptable if I use copper for this, aluminium here and another material here. Is it possible? Yes. Now that can be possible in terms of composite standard conductor. Composite is nothing but here we can utilize different types of material for our conductor. So which type of material we are having? I think we have rubbed that one. Yes, we have rubbed that one. So which type of material you are, yes, tell me. Which type of material we can use for our conductor? Yes.
Aluminium, copper, yes. Silver.
Very gold. Good. Very good. So we can use aluminium, we can use copper, we can use gold, we can use silver, we can use steel, we can use bronze, we can use iron, any type of material we can use. And this is another example of composite standard conductor. So composite means what? We can use strands of different material. Okay, so what do you mean by strand? This is one strand. This is another strand. This is another strand. This is another strand. Correct? And after that, we will twist it to form a standard conductor. Okay. And now I'll introduce you one conductor that is nothing but ACSR conductor. And this is what we are observing in our day-to-day life. That is aluminium conductor steel reinforced. Means what? Here, as name is suggests, we are utilizing two types of standard material, which is goodly. Two types of material we are using in this particular conductor. Which one? Aluminium and steel. Very good. So, and nowadays in day-to-day life, we are using such kind of material. Okay. So this aluminium is not only ACSR, we are having bunch of material conductor. Okay. So you might have come across, which I listed for you here itself, you might have come across AEC. Yes, AEC means what? All aluminium conductor. Means what? Here there is no any steel material, they are all aluminium conductor. So we can say it is a homogeneous conductor. Again, there are another material, they are called as triple AC. Triple AC means what? All aluminium alloy conductor. Correct? Third one is what? AC AR. Likewise, here we are having ACCR. ACCR means aluminium conductor steel reinforced. This is nothing but aluminium conductor alloy reinforced. Okay, so these are the types of conductor available in the market, and it is being used as per their application. Okay, so this is just one example. You can mark out this one also. This is aluminium, all aluminium. This is all aluminium. I'll write down here shortly. This is all aluminium. This is aluminium plus alloy. And this one is aluminium conductor and alloy reinforced. Okay, so these are certain types of material being used for composite standard conductor. Okay, so let us see this example. What they are saying, this is my outer conductor. Okay, this is my one conductor. Okay, this is actually conductor. And inside that, what we are observing, this is called strands. So try to understand the difference between conductor and strands. These are the strands. The number of numerology, this what I look for, that is nothing but strands. Okay, so this is what this one. What they are saying, steel is at the central one and it is circulated by aluminium material and they are twisted. Okay, that's why it is called as ACSR, aluminium conductor steel reinforced. Along with ACSR, we will be having AAC, that is aluminium alloy conductor, triple AC, aluminium alloy, all aluminium alloy conductor. Then also we are having ACAR. So what do you mean by ACAR? Yes?
Aluminium conductor alloy reinforced.
Correct. Aluminium conductor alloy reinforced. Okay, this kind of such type of question you might be asked in your exam. Yes. Now, Let us move further. Okay, first we'll just go in detail. There is no need of this, but okay, we'll just let's see what the time is remaining, because you have to solve certain type of example also. Okay, first we will move further, then we'll come back, because this is the theoretical one. Okay. White West will cover it separately. Okay. What they are saying, as the layer size is increased, obviously, this is my first layer, this is my second layer, this is my third layer, and this goes on increasing. Correct? Yes, obviously, it goes on increasing. So, as the layer size is increased, the number of strand will gonna increase. Because, yes, let us see. This is my first conductor. This is my first layer, first conductor. Now, this layer is accumulated by number of conductors. So, here they are accumulated 6 conductors. So, first is the first layer, this is second layer. Now, in next layer, they are accumulated with the how many? 12. Then 18. Then 24. Okay. Now, have you come across certain scenario that is known as square mm? Yes. What does it represent? Square mm. What does it represent? Yes, anyone? No one has come across this one? Okay, so this is nothing but representation of size of cables. Size of cables, which is nothing but they just represent the cross-sectional area of particular cable in terms of square mm. Okay, so it is starting with the 2.5, 4, then 10, then 16. So these range gonna increase, and how it happens? It happens because based on this, how many layers you are utilizing for this your particular conductor. So means for some cases you can enough with this one. Some cases you can enough with this one. So this layer, how you gonna increase? It represents the size. Means what? As the layer size is increased, number of strands will increase in this kind of aspect. So accordingly, your size of the cable gonna increase. So this is what they are trying to say in this particular things. Only the point to be noted in this ACSR is nothing but what? In our power conductor, number of aluminum conductor are more compared to the steel one. It is what they are saying, steel reinforced. So at the central, we will use certain kind of steel material, and to have the better strength, we will use aluminium. Okay, this is what about ECSR conductor, and it belongs. So the question might ask, ECSR conductors are belongs to which kind of category? So what's the answer? It is a solid, homogeneous, or composite. Definitely it comes under the category of composite standard conductor. Okay, yet now we have reach at the fourth type of conductor, that is nothing but bundle conductor. Okay. This is bundle conductor, and this is what our aim is, what we are looking for, types of conductor or parameter of transmission line. Okay, now we have understood the yes, such type of trans means what kind of material I'm using for the transmission line. Accordingly, I will go further to study the particular effect of that parameter on the transmission line. Okay, until I don't know the which type of material I'm using and how my element will behave with that particular conductor, there is no use of study this power system. Okay, so what we have looked for? We have looked for the solid, we have looked for the bundle. We are looking for the bundle, and we are looking for the stranded one. Okay, so let us see bundle conductor. Okay, at name itself, we are binding certain type of conductor at one particular things to avoid what? Corona loss, to avoid interference with communication line and much more. So when your voltage rating goes beyond 230 kilovolt, then there is a more chances of corona loss. There is a more chances of interference with the communication cable. So what do you mean by this interference? Okay. I will give you one domestic example, and then I will move for the industrial one. Okay, this is my transmission line. Okay, it is passing from my house. This is building is there. And along with it, we are having certain our dish antenna, or we can say cable, your TV cable. It is also passing in accordance with this cable. So after some time interval, if there is a bad weather condition or certain types of another windy condition or then rainy season, you can observe your television is having certain kind of disturbance on your signal. Have you observed this one? Kele ka observe kadi?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Why it happens? Because we are having a power scenario, and when it comes the power, AC power, there is a role of frequency, and each frequency are starting, whether it is a radio frequency, whether it is TV signal frequency, all are working with some kind of frequency. And when we are saying we are using certain type of high voltage, there definitely we are having interference with some kind of communication line. So yes, now get back to the industrial one. When I was working in certain Cummins India Limited, they are strictly, the design engineer strictly warn us that what he want, he says, don't use your power cable. So this is nothing but a tray. This is a cable laying tray. Don't use a power cable along with your HVAC power cable or HVAC cable. HVAC means what? Your AC line, which is being installed in industrial premises. You cannot use this one. Along with that, they have given certain distance to be kept between this power line and communication line. Okay, because they are saying, the designer is saying, there have been chances of communication or interference between this one. Okay, so they have given certain range. I know that particular range still, that is 50 to 150 mm between power and your other communicating devices. Okay, whether it is smoke detector, whether it is all any kind of fire alarm. So there should be certain kind of avoidance in between interference. So this is nothing but interference communication. Now this is what, this example was about domestic and industrial, but when we are living in open atmosphere, of course, don't you think there should be another interference occurrence? Obviously it is there. So bundle conductor is come in picture, and they are saying I can use or I can utilize a high voltage surface gradient, which will be reduced with the help of certain conductor, that is nothing but bundling. We are bundling. Now word is saying that what we are actually referring for. We are using such type of bundle conductor to avoid certain atmospheric factor. Okay, so I have given the example of domestic, industrial. But what will be the atmospheric example in our real time? Windy condition, snowy condition, smoke is there, humidity is there, moisture is there, not humidity, moisture is there. So because of this, there might get chances of this conductor to weaken their performance, to lose their strength. Correct? And that's why, best example I will give you. If you have a copper cable and it is not carrying any kind of insulation and it is open to the atmosphere for some duration, suppose it is in a winter season, or suppose it is a summer season, after some time interval, you can observe some kind of rusting on that particular conductor. Have you observed rust on particular conductor? Have you observed such things? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Everyone has observed this one. Why? Because each material have certain parameter. Each material have certain limitation. And when it comes to the atmosphere, definitely there might get chances of losing this strength. Now think of this power system. We are transmitting such huge amount of power as per your customer demand to your load center. Don't you think there should be that much kind of material we should use for this particular conductor? Definitely. And that's why we are using bundle conductor, where your voltage gradient, your surface voltage gradient is the most important concern. Surface voltage gradient is most important concern. It will affect your wind system. Now, this is just an example. This you can consider any atmospheric criteria can be get eliminated with the help of, I'm saying eliminated, not total. This is not an ideal one. Okay, nothing is ideal one because it's a certain kind of material. Okay, after it, each material has certain duration. After that, they loosen their strength. They start losing their strength. So this is about bundle conductor. Okay, now how we can say this bundle conductor can be grouped together to form a better strength? Correct. आतापर्यंत आपण काय बघितलंय? We have used, started with the single, then we have with the standard. So we have homogeneous standard conductor, we have composite standard conductor. Now you know the basic difference between single conductor and composite standard conductor. Okay, now after that we look for bundle. So bundle is nothing but all, he have taken all the advantage of solid stranded conductor. Okay, that is nothing but bundle conductor. So bundle means what? We are combining certain types of conductor for the particular application. Okay, so let us start with the for mathematical model. Okay, yes, so first one is what? Here we are having two conductors. Now this is one phase, this is another phase, two conductor per phase. So we will say, now we will not go in detail of derivation because the derivation part is not in your gate syllabus. We just only need to keep in mind the formula. Okay, so this bundle conductor is having, what is having? Two conductors. Okay, here I have written out certain scenario. I started with the bundle conductor with the grouping of two. This is a grouping of three, this is a grouping of four, and it goes on increasing. Okay, there is no limitation, it goes on increasing. But as per the GMR, geometric mean radius, what they are saying, if you just combine these two conductor, if you just combine these two conductor, I'll achieve a derivation of a equation of square root of ds into d. Now the ds in d is what they have to look further. If I use three conductor, the equation will become ds into d, and it is a cubic root. If I move further, equation will be this one. So what you understood? What you understood means what? As soon as you're gonna increase the grouping of the conductor, number of conductor per phase, your derivation is gonna change, correct? And this is the design parameter of transmission line. And here we have started with the mathematical model. Here I'll not add you a derivation because it is already covered in, for B student, it is already covered. For T student, you have to hold for some time, but you can right now in this situation, you can keep equation in your mind. Okay, so this is how we are going to bundle number of conductor. How you can going to bundling, this is called as bundling process. I have two conductors. If a requirement increase, I'll add one, three conductor, I'm gonna add four, I'm gonna add five. So this goes on increasing and according to your equation also. This is called bundle conductor. Now, whatever the conductor we have seen so far, now we will see the implementation in terms of where we can implement this one in our transmission line. But when we are saying transmission line, definitely for design perspective, there should be some model. So that model will tell us or describe us how there should be arrangement of this transmission line, how we are connecting this conductor throughout this transmission line. So based on that, we'll call it as transmission line module. Correct? Is it clear? So what we have looked so far? So we have seen the power electrical energy. We have seen certain types of power factors, not power factor in terms of that particular cost phi. I'm talking about the power factor in terms of particular energy consumption. Then we have seen certain types of power plant engineering. Then we have looked for need of, we also look for SLD, single line diagram. Then we have looked for different types of transmission system. Yes, after that, we look for necessity of transmission line. Then we have started with the solid conductor. We have started with the homogeneous stranded conductor. Then we have started with the composite stranded conductor. And finally, we have come across bundle conductor. Okay, so this bundle conductor is most important thing. So after this, we will start with the transmission line module, where we will look over what are the transmission line module, which are the element we are using or we are observing in transmission line module. So we'll start with this one. Okay, so before that, it's 1 hour. We will have 2 minutes break. So in this, I will give you one link for which is called a feedback link, and then we'll start with this one. So it might be some 2 minutes break also. Then in fresh start, we will start the methodology. And I'm requesting to all of you to have a calculator with you, because now we have reached with our calculation part. I will elaborate certain types of example and we will start with the actual methodology. Okay, so I'm posting this link in chat box. I request all of you to access this particular link. This is nothing but your feedback link. And as soon as complete this one, please let me know. We will move further. Okay, I hope you all have started with this. Yes. Take your time. And within 2 minutes, we'll start next session. Yes, rest of the student also, please make it fast. Okay, shall we start? Okay. Okay, am I audible? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So we'll start. Okay. I hope you have 2 minutes break is sufficient. Okay. So we'll start with the transmission module. Yes. For this transmission module is, it is nothing but whatever the devices, whatever the equipment we are using, that now we are actually connecting in terms of some kind of technical, that is nothing but your transmission module. So module is nothing but we are elaborating or we are connecting certain types of devices, whether it is inductor, whether it is resistance, whether it is your voltage source, your receiving source. So all these are getting connected along with certain transmission line. So that is nothing but your transmission line model. Okay, so here this model is representing your transmission line. Okay, this is the most important approach. Yes. So what they are saying, a transmission line is used for transmission of electric power from generating substation to various distribution units, correct? Yeah. So this is what we have learned or what we already know, what this use of this transmission line. Yes. Now, we will see the performance. Okay. Only the use is sufficient? No. If it is performs well, if my equipment will performs well, then it is, I'll say it is useful for my electrical system. So we will study the performance of this transmission line with the help of, now if I want to check the performance of transmission line, definitely I will look over on the parameter of that particular transmission line. And this is nothing but our topic is what we are looking for. Performance of transmission line and this line parameter, and then after we look for the corona effect. So yes, tell me, in which conductor we have seen the corona loss? Right now we have just completed this part, corona. Which conductor? Okay, so in 2 minutes, like, you forgot all things. Yes, when your line voltage is goes in beyond to 30 kilovolt, then we refer the corona loss. Is it clear? Yes. Now we will see the performance of transmission line. Now this performance of transmission line will depends on the elements of circuit, or here the element is called as parameter of my particular line. Okay, so when you are on the DC circuit, a chota sa circuit or the DC circuit, then you might have come across the resistance, you might have come across the inductance, you might have come across the capacitance, correct? Now this move from DC to small AC to large AC. So here, what we look for? We look for same element, but here we'll call it as parameter of that particular transmission line. Okay, so which are the parameter? Definitely, we will again start with the resistance, inductance and capacitance. But here the role of this RLC will be different, and that on the basis of the performance of this resistance, the performance of inductance and performance of this capacitance, we will look for performance of transmission line, because these are the three material, these are the three parameter who will decide the performance of transmission line. Correct? Yes. So let us, we'll go in detail, but here we will just see the basic part of R, basic part of L and basic part of C. So resistance is what? It is due to the property of the conductor. Definitely it will oppose the flow of current. This is what we know. So the, where it is placed in the transmission line model, this is my resistance. Okay. Now what do you mean by inductance? Due to the magnetic field around the conductor. So where it is placed in accordance with the resistance, in series with the resistance, that is inductance. And capacitance is what? Due to the electrostatic field around the conductor. Definitely, when my conductor overhead line is in the atmosphere, so it will experience inductive magnetic field and electrostatic field. So if my conductor is experiencing electromagnetic field, so whatever the amount of current flowing through that conductor, definitely there is a formation of inductor, and it will show the property of inductance. Definitely, when I'll say this is my first inductor, where it is, this is my first inductor and this is my second inductor. Now what we are saying, three phase, three wire, or three phase, four wire. So among these, I'm considering the one, this two wire is nothing but this one. Okay, so I'm representing this two wire. If one conductor is carrying certain electric field, another is carrying certain amount of current, so definitely there is a formation of certain capacitance. Why? Because this conductor is representing one charge plate, this is another charge plate, and between these I can observe capacitance. Okay, so I'll tell you here, you cannot observe your resistance, your inductor and capacitance physically. Just as tumhala DC circuit madhe, you can observe here resistance element, which is consist of some band, and on that band you are going to form that BB Roy Great Britain rule. Here you can observe some certain kinds of copper coil placing over here, it is in circular shape. Asa kahi tumhala ita disnar nahi. So these are just gonna experiencing this element, and this element will have the effect on power system. Mahi effect tumhala disat nahi, you cannot visualize this one, but you can observe in terms of your performance. Whether hip element present or still, definitely my performance of transmission line gonna change. Definitely, yes. So based on that, we will move for the our first topic, that is resistance of transmission line. Okay. Yes. So what is resistance? You know, the resistance of transmission line conductors is the most important and cause the power loss. Why power loss? Because we already say it opposes the flow of current, and when anything is opposing, there is a heat dissipation, and heat dissipation in the conductor definitely will cause my power, because power is nothing but what? P is equal to voltage into current. So definitely it is opposing at this, means there is a direct equation to the power, so your power get lost. Yes, so you know this basic equation. See what we are doing here, we are using our basic equation and we are modifying in terms of our three phase form parameter. Okay, so this is your basic equation for DC, this is basic equation for single phase DC, where we are saying R is equal to rho into L by A, where rho is my resistivity, L is nothing but length of that particular conductor, and A is the area of cross section. Okay, and when we are saying the power loss, you might have remember there is a one factor, that is temperature, because heat dissipation, resistance and the heat dissipation is the most interlinked concept. Correct? When there is heat dissipation, obviously there is a temperature coefficient is there. Okay, Clear? So we will say the resistance in my transmission line, I'll represent as a single one. This is for single one. When we move further for solving certain example, I hope now you are ready with your calculator. Okay, because now we are going to solve certain numerical. Okay, so let us see how much time permits us. We will move accordingly. Okay, so this is resistance. Now let's talk about inductance. Here we will not go in detail of the derivation. I will simply write down here. I will write down here simply its formula. And believe me, in your GATE examination also, or any kind of competitive examination, nowadays we are moving for the quality approach. Okay, now no one will ask for you writing derivation. Okay, they will simply ask one numerical, which is the base of that particular derivation. So simply just keep in mind certain equation, certain this formula, and you will able to solve all the types of numerical. Okay, yes. Now next part, this is the second part, that is nothing but inductance. First part was about resistance. Now this is inductance. Then we will have a third part that we'll see further, that is about capacitance. And this is what we are learning in our transmission line. Yes. So inductance of a two wire line. What they are saying? Inductance of a transmission line is defined as the number of flux linkage produced per ampere of current flowing through the line. Okay. So inductance per conductor. What I'm saying? Inductance per conductor is given as, suppose this is my inductor, this is my one conductor, this is my another conductor. So this conductor is surrounded by certain electromagnetic field. Definitely this conductor is carrying certain amount of current, so definitely it will experience inductance. So I will say this is my one conductor, this is my another conductor, this is my another conductor. So I'll say this is my three phase. How much wire? How much wire? Three phase?
Three wire.
Three wire. Okay, three phase, three wire. Now I'm saying inductance per conductor. So this L1 is for this one, this L2 is for this one, this L3 is for this one. This 1, 2, 3 are this nomenclature. You can say LA, LB, LC as per your convenience, no doubt. But the mostly thing is what? We have derived a certain equation that is saying L is nothing but 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln D upon R dash Henry per meter. Okay, so Henry represents my inductor and meter is nothing but length of that particular conductor. Correct? Yes. Now, if you modify this one, if I'm comparing the inductance along with the another inductor, like this inductor along with this another inductor, then what will be my formula? So I will call this that loop inductance. Okay, or inductance of both conductor. Please make sure, I'll rub it so you will not be get confused. So please make sure there are two formula. One is inductor per conductor, and this is the inductance of both the conductors. So here there we have added, please keep in mind, we have added LA and we have added LB. So LA, LB is nothing but your inductance per conductor. Means whatever the inductance of this conductor, whatever inductance of this conductor, that will give me inductance of both. Okay, so here that is called as loop inductance, or we have add that particular things. Okay, so right now you can note down this equation, because we are going to solve some numerical based on this. That is, inductance per conductor is given as 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln capital D. So D is the diameter of that particular conductor, and R dash. So R dash is nothing but we have the direct value of 0.788 into R. So R is nothing but radius of that particular conductor. Okay, Henry per meter. Clear? And for loop inductance, if you just simply add, so this is of same size, same length, same size, that's why it is as just get multiply with the 2. Means it's a double of it. So it will obtain the equation 4 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln D by R, distance between the conductor, then R dash, radius of that particular conductor. Henry per meter. Okay, so whatever the square bracket I have made, you can just note down that one. You can note down only three things. Inductor, inductance per conductor is what? R dash is what? And loop inductance means what? You have 1 minute, so you can just note down it. I hope you are done. Yes. So what we have looked for? We have looked for inductance of two wire. Okay. But what we are saying, there might be in three phase, there might be three wire or four wire. Okay. Now same formula we will apply for symmetrical three phase line. Yes. So here what they are saying, this was limited when we are having only two parallel conductor. Now we are, so what we are looking for? We are looking for the number of possibilities of the conductor can be placed for this overhead transmission line. That's it. Okay. So what they are saying, when we look for the three phase symmetrical conductor, now symmetrical means what? The distance between three conductor will remain same. That is symmetric. So this D and this D will remain same. But what was the case in this one? These are only two conductors. So that's why this distance doesn't matter whether it is symmetrical or unsymmetrical, because this is only single distance. But among these, if I added third one, this is another method or another possibility of arranging the conductor. So that is nothing but this one, okay, which is called as inductance of symmetrical three phase line. Okay. Now you know the inductance of conductor. What is it? 2 into 10 raised to minus 7 ln d upon r dash. Where we got the one? This one, we got this equation at this stage. Inductance of single conductor. Now the inductance of conductor B and C will also the same, correct? Yes. So the inductance of three phase line is equal to the two wire line. Means what? Let me tell you. Yes. What they are saying, the distance between, suppose this is my A conductor, this is my B conductor, and this one is my C conductor. The distance between this one and this one, suppose I'll say this is 5 kilometer. This is 5 kilometer, this one is 5 kilometer. Clear? Yes. Here what we have seen, inductance of this one, inductance of this one, we have calculated individual one, and then we have simply add. That's why it is come as 4 × 10⁻¹. Here what we are saying, individual inductance is nothing but given by this equation. Individual inductance given by this equation. Same individual inductance is look at this equation, obviously. But when we are going to find out the cumulative inductance, that is nothing but only addition of all this. Why? Because they are placing at equidistance from each other. So here it is 5, here it is 5, here it is 5. So that is comes under the category of symmetrical three-phase line. Okay. Yes, so here what we have written, but here the distance is nothing but your 5 kilometer, here 5 kilometer, here 5 kilometer. So here only the distance is the important factor for the consideration. So what we have added here, 2 × 10⁻¹, it remains same. Yes, ln d. So here d is nothing but what? It was only between two conductor. Here distance is nothing but a cumulative of distance between A and B, distance between B and C, and distance between A and C. This is what the way of inductances of unsymmetrical. But when we say it is symmetrical, so distance will remain same. So here it simply d is equal to 5, simply. But when it is unsymmetrical, so it is unsymmetrical, so now here it will not come as 5, here it will come as 15 kilometer, it will come as 50 kilometer, and this is 5. Now I'll say this is my unsymmetrical conductor. Okay, clear? So just note down this equation for the calculation. This is for unsymmetrical, this is for symmetrical, and this is for individual one. Okay, I'll rub it and I'll just make a simple box so we'll have. This one, you can note down this one, and this is cumulative one. Then after, this is another one, and for unsymmetrical, you will be having this one, correct? So means what? These symmetrical means all the conductor are equally transposed. So there is one term that is called as transpose. Okay, this all inductors are being equally transposed, so that we are saying it is a inductance of symmetrical three-phase line. Clear? Okay, yes. We can note down this one for inductance of unsymmetrical three-phase line. Yes, I hope you have done. You can note down this one also. These both are same actually. This one and this one are mostly same because they are symmetrical. Only it get added. So here we have added 2. Here we'll add all the 3s. So what we have looked for, okay, one more is yet to complete. Then we will just summarize what we have looked for. Okay, so what we have seen the resistance, we have seen the capacitance, inductance. Now the next one is capacitance. Okay, so capacitance between two wire line. Okay, so the equation for this one is nothing but, so how we have understood the capacitance? Suppose this is my one conductor, this is my another conductor, and this is my third conductor. Okay, there might be a chances. Now this conductor is carrying certain amount of current. Yes, this conductor is carrying certain amount of current. Capacitance means was two parallel plate facing with a dielectric material. So here dielectric material is what? Kaya so chakta hita? Dielectric material?
Here.
So there might be chances of existing of capacitor. And definitely if element is there, then definitely it will show their properties. So these are nothing but two conductors are placing at certain distance, that is distance D. So these are two lines, so that's why we'll call it as line-to-line capacitance. And if you remember, in terms of conductor, we are calculated in terms of per phase. So inductance per phase, and this is between line-to-line. Okay, this is point to be noted. Okay, so the capacitors, just a sec. Yes. So the capacitance of line to line. And if you just, that's why I always say you should be a good observer. This is inductance per conductor. Means this is individual inductance, this is individual inductance, and then we get added. Now in terms of capacitance, this is not the case. Here, the capacitance between this line and this line give the total capacitance. That is nothing but C AB. So EAB is nothing but representation of A conductor and representation of B conductor. Okay, so we know the basic equation. Capacitor is nothing but, or we have written here like this one, Q is equal to CV. You will just modify it. C is equal to charge upon electric volt, electric field. Okay, so QC is equal to Q by V. So here, if you modify this derivation, we will come to the final equation as capacitance is nothing but your pi into epsilon into ln D by R farad per meter. So per meter value is will be always be there. Correct? Now, if we modify this one, if I'm saying there is a one zero potential capacitance between each conductor and the point of zero potential, if it is neutral, is get added. So this was what? Line to line. Okay. But when I'm saying this is four wire, so definitely there is one of them is the neutral one. So in that condition, why? Because inductance is like this one. There is no such inductance of this conductor and this conductor get linked, but there is the chances of capacitance. Correct? Yes. So if there is a neutral point, so capacitance is nothing but line to neutral. So in that case, your equation get modified by multiplying factor 2. Okay? So you can note down this also. The equation for line to line inductor capacitance, and this is the equation for line to neutral. Okay, so such type of equation also might be asked in your exam. Okay, so this you have to just multiply it by 2. Okay, so this is your capacitance between line to neutral, and this is the capacitance between line to line. Okay, you can note down this one. No need to write down this one, this part. This is again a part of derivation. Only write down this one. Okay. Now let's look for capacitance of three-phase overhead line. Okay, likewise, we have seen the inductance of symmetrical one. In same way, we will look for the capacitance of symmetrical and unsymmetrical spacing. So capacitance is nothing but, we know, suppose this is a star manner, then definitely there will be a neutral point. Correct? So this is how there is a finding of neutral point is there. Correct? Now, when we'll say there is a existing of capacitance, definitely between the two conductors. So this is one capacitance and this is the capacitance. This will one capacitance, this is another capacitance. So if they are symmetrical or unsymmetrical, now what gonna change in symmetrical and unsymmetrical?
Distance
between the conductor gonna change. So your equation, whatever the equation which we have designed for the capacitance, is remain same only when it is unsymmetrical capacitance, only distance is gonna change.
Okay, likewise in inductance also we have seen the distance have changed. Correct? Here also the distance have changed. Okay, so this is another example of capacitance of three phase overhead line. Okay, so you can please note down this one also.
Yes, I hope you have done it. Yes. Now we have reached to our final point, and then we'll start with the actual
solving the problem.
Okay. So first we'll compare all these parameters along with what we are looking for. Let me know what we are looking for. What is our aim? We are looking for the performance of transmission line, and for that we will look for different parameter of transmission line. This is RM. Okay, so we will discuss all these on the basis of inductance, resistance, and capacitance. Clear? Yes. This is most important slide of overall the presentation. Okay, because here I have ended our all the mathematical part or technical part, and after that we'll start numerical, which have been asked in GATE exam. Okay, so for your convenience, if you want, you can take a screenshot of it, or at the end or tomorrow I will provide all this 2-hour session on your Google Drive. Okay, don't worry. Yes. Yes. For first we listed out what we have learned, and then we'll move for the problem. Correct? Yes. So moral of this overall the session is what? That we come to know that transmission line has mainly certain parameter. Your resistance is there, your inductance is there, your capacitance is there, and these parameters are uniformly distributed along the line. Okay, so that's why your transmission line is also called as distributed parameter of this particular transmission line. Correct? And whatever the this RLC you have learned in your DC network, an AC, your single AC, that is nothing but lump network. Here, these are distributed one. And that's why your KCL, KVL are not applicable for this kind of system, this kind of network. In network analysis, you might come across this one, lump network and distributed network. So these are nothing but your distributed parameter of transmission line. Correct? Again, on the basis of these, there are, again, what we have looked for, we have looked for the model. There are certain models. You might have come across pi model, you might have come across t model. So these are the arrangement of that particular parameter. Okay, so let us just revise. Also, you have come across certain ABCD parameter. So ABCD parameter of transmission is nothing but what? These are the constant. Your A, B, C, and D, these are the constant of your transmission line, and which is used for the analysis of that particular electrical network. Okay, and that's why the power system is the one field where we are mostly focusing on the ABCD parameter, then performance of the parameter, line parameter. These are the much more important things to be considered in power system. Okay, so this was the moral, or we can say, or summary of this today's session. Now we look into this table and we will try to summarize in technical way. Okay, so whatever the technical session we have learned so far, we will just summarize in this particular slide. Yes, so here I have listed out parameter. So I have the resistance, I have the inductance, I have the inductive reactance, capacitance, and inductive capacitance. So you know the relation between L and XL, you know the relation between C and XC. So one is increasing, one is at one thing, it is opposite to others. Correct? Yes. So length. First point is length. If the length of my bundle, or what, which type of conductor? Transmission line. So in that particular transmission line, I'm looking for bundle conductor. Okay. So length of my transmission line, or being specific, length of my bundle conductor is increased. So which parameter going to increase? Yes. Resistance is going to increase. Inductance is going to increase. Inductive reactance is going to increase. Capacitance is going to increase. And you know C and XC are inversely proportional. So if C is increasing, XC is decreasing. Correct? You know the relation for XL is equal to what? 2 pi. And XC is equal to what? 1 upon. Okay, you know this one. So on that basis, this table has been derived. Now, this one is about length, and another is distance of separation. Can anyone tell me what is the difference between length and distance? Yes. What do you understand by this? Length and distance. Yes, anyone? is present over here?
Distance between two conductors increases.
Yeah, very good. So length is nothing but a length of the conductor, whether it is started at this particular point and now that conductor is spreading all about 20 kilometer, 50 kilometer, 10 kilometer. That is the length. Distance is if the conductor is of system is of three phase, three wire. So the distance between these three conductor. Okay, suppose distance between these three conductor, that is nothing but D. So nomenclature here is D for this distance, and nomenclature here is L, that is for length. Okay, now you know the resistance belongs among the conductor. So there is no relation between the distance is increasing or not. Okay, resistance is what? It opposes the flow through the conductor. तुमच्या साईडने जो कंडक्टर जातो त्यातला तो अपोज करतो का? नो, देर इज नो रिलेशन. ओके, दिस इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग. देन येस, इंडक्टन्स इट गेट अफेक्टेड, कॅपॅसिटन्स गेट डिक्रीजेस जर तुमचा डिस्टन्स वाढला. ओके, थर्ड वन इज रेडियस ऑफ द कंडक्टर, मीन्स वॉट? युअर डायमीटर इज गोना इन्क्रीज. रेजिस्टन्स वाढली म्हणजे तुमचं काय? डायमीटर वाढली. सपोज दिस इज रेडियस ऑफ 1 meter अँड दिस इज माय रेडियस ऑफ 2 meter. If radius of conductor gonna increase, then resistance will decrease, inductance will decrease, capacitance will increase. How? Let's see. Suppose this is my one conductor. And now I have to make something specific. Just one thing. Okay. What we are looking for? Radius of particular conductor. Suppose this is my one conductor. This is my another conductor. And this distance is nothing but between the center. So suppose it is 4 kilometer. Okay. And another situation is what? Now this distance, I have replaced this conductor by increasing radius. Replace this conductor by increasing radius. So as soon as increase the radius, so distance between the conductor is what? This is going to decrease, and that's why your capacitance is going to increase. Current capacitance ka asto, it exists between the two conductor. Mata he jar maje distance he distance kami hote na maje from surface to surface, so there is more chances of increasing capacitance. Okay, so as soon as my radius is going to increase, your capacitance is going to increase. In same way, symmetrical spacing. So what do you mean by symmetrical spacing and unsymmetrical spacing? So symmetrical spacing, there is no relation, obviously. So resistance has only the active in length of the conductor. There is no significance of resistance in power transmission line. It only related to the length of the conductor. Whatever the length, along that it exhibits some power loss, heat dissipation, temperature. Okay, we have to mostly consider inductance and capacitance. So symmetrical spacing, obviously your inductance gonna decrease, your capacitance gonna increase, because uniform conductor your capacitance is much more. Ununiform conductor your inductance is more and your capacitance is less. Now effect of earth, whether it is we have taken the effect of earth, suppose this is my conductor and this is my earth, so which parameter will affect my performance of transmission line? Obviously resistance, we have already closed it. Inductance, we have already closed it. Yes, capacitance gets affected because there is also a chance of forming capacitance between your conductor and your earth. Therefore the chances of capacitance, so that's why we should keep a well valued distance between your conductor and earth. Okay, and then height of the conductor increases. Then this is also not economical for to avoid the capacitance. I will hang out this particular conductor on very too much height. No, This is again one concern. So yes, because of the increase in height, definitely my inductance capacitance will reduce, but it will add on another parameter. Okay, so all parameter, so among considering why this is show, I'll showing to you, considering all this parameter versus all this element, we will able to identify at which means what there are certain drawback, there are certain limitations also, there are certain advantage also, there are certain drawback also. Means what? If we add on something, then definitely there is some effect on other. Okay, so we will find out some middle point, and with this middle point we will come, we will try to calculate or try to identify the performance of transmission line. And this was our today's agenda. We are look for the basic of performance of transmission line, which are the different line parameter and the corona. So corona was the only concern with the distance and that particular voltage rating. Okay, now we will look into the example. As I know there is a only 5 or 10 minutes are left, 5 minutes left. Okay, so no doubt we'll start with the one example, a basic example. In next session we will continue, but at least if I take one or two example, we are able to link up what we have learned today. Okay, yes, so this is the example which have been asked in GATE exam. Okay, yes, I know save our time during this session, I have used a screenshot because that is more flexible to understood you also and to teach. Yeah, so the problem is what? I will read out the inductance of transmission line. First, don't look over this. Okay, first we'll read out the problem and then we'll see what it is actually asked for. What they are saying, the inductance of a transmission line increases. So means they are asking inductance of transmission line is increases with what? So we have the option increases with decrease in length. Okay, length. So what they are saying, if length is increased, your inductance is what? Increasing. What they are saying, if inductance of transmission line increases, this is decreases. So means this is not correct. Correct. So this is how we are able to apply what we have learned. Second, increase in diameter of the conductor. Obviously not, because if you find the relation between the inductor, okay, for clear visualization, we will go back to the, our inductance formula. Yes. What is inductance is inversely proportional to the radius. So R dash is nothing but 0.778 into the radius of the conductor. Correct. Means what? This is also incorrect. Now, increase in the spacing between the phase conductor. Definitely increase in the spacing. Increase in the spacing means what? Means what? Distance of separation. If you increase the spacing between the conductor or distance of separation between the conductor, definitely inductance is gonna increase and capacitor is gonna decrease. This is what they have asked in GATE exam. Correct. Now you have come to know what we have looked for. Okay, so your correct option is nothing but your C. Have you understood? Have you how we apply this performance of transmission line and line parameter? Okay, so that's why I'm saying you can just take a screenshot. It is very important from all the competitive examination and all the GATE examination point of view. Okay, yes. We'll see one more example. Which one is the most related to this one? We'll take this one. It will take very less time. Okay, so what this example is, the conductors of 10 kilometer long. So 10 kilometer long is nothing but what they have given, length of that particular conductor. Okay, this is length. Single phase two wire separated by a distance of 1.5. suppose these are how many phases are there? Yes, how many phases are there?
Single phase.
And how many wires are there?
Two wire.
Two wires. So this is not correct. We will need only two one. Correct? Yes. So the two conductors are there. Two phase, single phase, two conductors, and these are separated by distance 1.5. So this is distance D. This is a representation of actual one, but your theoretical, how you gonna represent like this one. This is just, but most of the students get confused between this one. That's why I'm representing in a practical way. So this is my one conductor. This is my another conductor. Distance is nothing but 1.5 meter. Okay. The diameter of each conductor is 1 centimeter. Diameter means this one. This is 1 centimeter. Each conductor. Each conductor means what they are trying to say? Both conductor are of same size. Correct? Means this diameter is 1 centimeter and this one diameter is 1 centimeter. Please read it carefully. This is diameter. And but in actual, in our equation, what we required? We required radius. So we will just make it half. One more thing. Most of the students get confused between this D and this D. The diameter is never been asked in your inductance. It is asked for the radius. So definitely less half it. And this is the distance between the two conductors. Okay. Clear. Now, if the conductors are of copper and the inductance of circuit is, so they are asking for, if they are copper conductor, then inductance of the circuit is. Now tell me whether there is any relation between the material of the conductor and the inductance formula. Have you find out any relation?
No.
No. So this is just to make you confuse. There is no such relation to find out the inductance. Okay, if they ask for, if I use the copper, what will the mechanical strength, what will the tensile strength? In that case, yes, we will take into consideration. But here, there is no need. Okay, so what the formula for inductance? What is the formula? What's the formula? This one. Okay, we will just apply, we will just put all the values in this, what they are saying. 0.2 into ln d upon r dash. So here d is nothing but what? 1.5 centimeter. So this is distance between the conductor. R dash. So you know r dash means what? 0.788 into r. So r is nothing but what? R is, they have given 1 centimeter, but we will make it radius. D is the diameter, but we will require radius. So we will make it half. Now it is in centimeter, so we will write it as 10 raised to minus 2, and it is in, comes in a meter. Okay, we will put all the values here. Now, why this two multiplication is there? Because they are of same material and same size. Correct? So 0.4 into ln, we will put the value of distance of separation 1.5 and r dash. So r dash is nothing but 0.788, your radius, and you, this is 10 raised to minus 2. And if you solve this, you will have, so that's why I'm saying you be with the calculator. Okay. Your GATE exam, there is a virtual calculator available on the screen. So you can use that one, no doubt. Okay. So value will come as 2.38 millihenry per kilometer. Why kilometer? Because they have write down to find out in kilometer. But now the question is, we have not mentioned here kilometer. Correct? If you remember the formula, what I have said, these are the inductance per conductor, per length. So here length is in meter. Now we have, what we have found out, that is in kilometer. Okay. And they have been asked for 10 kilometer. So we'll simply multiply it by 10. So we will get the values of inductance of that particular circuit, that is 23.8 millihenry. Okay. Have you understood? Yes. So what we are actually using, we are just fulfilling the whatever the equation we have obtained, and this is not the problem which I have prepared. This is I have taken out from the Made Easy notes, or I have taken out from the Google, where we have seen such type of gate example being asked in your power system syllabus. Okay, so I have listed out certain much more example. We will see this in next session. Okay, I think this is enough for today's session. This was being time bounded. We have 2 hour session, and we have ended with this basic criteria. Correct? Yes. So let me stop this recording first.